Okay, very good evening. Welcome to Maya in a Minute. Today, a small tip about using bump maps and using a single file to create auto bump maps in Maya. Now, this is an old technique that we've used multiple times, but a lot of people do ask me about that again and again. So, for example, if I create a plane and I need to assign it a bump map. So, typically, we would assign a bump map and create a grayscale image from Photoshop and then import it into it. But you can do that within Maya itself. So what you need to do is, if you create an object, for example, if I assign it a particular material, and if I go into color map, and if I go into file, let me assign a single file. Now what that basically means, for example, if I assign it, maybe this one would work. Click open, press 6, that should, press 6 one. Material. Right click, assign existing material, number 2. And if I press 6, here we go. And then very quickly, if I go into polygons, create UVs, planar mapping, and since I'm looking from top view, let me project, and that's here we go. So we have this object available, and in order to assign a bump map, I need to create a separate material within our Photoshop. But what we can do very quickly is, you can go into rendering editors and Hypershade, and open up the Hypershade. Here you have material available, right click, graph network, this graph network is available. Now what you can do is that there are very cool utilities available within Maya itself. These utilities basically allow you to work with other textures, files, rigging, and lots of things you can do within Maya that basically allows you to take some settings and work with them. So for example, if you can look for something called RGB to luminance, what this would do is it would convert the RGB information into a grayscale luminance information. Then there's a node called reverse, would use that as well. This reverse node, what this reverse node will do is it will reverse the black to white and white to black. So now simply if I place it here, middle mouse click, file, and drop it onto this texture, RGB luminance connected with value. So what this would do now is that this RGB is connected with luminance. What this node will do is take all the RGB information and convert it into a grayscale image or black and white image. Then we need to reverse the polarities, in other words, black to white, white to black. So middle mouse click and drag it, drop it onto here, click on the input. A connection editor would open, just click on the value to input. So this would basically mean that we are connecting manually the RGB input values to an basically reverse node's input value. So this value is being connected with that thing. Now this information has been passed to the reverse node. Then just click and drag and drop this reverse node onto your material node and connect it with your bump map. Once you do that, basically we have an output. Output X needs to be connected with the bump value. That this value will now drive how much bump you need in your image. So if I click on that, close on that, and obviously you should see a small bump appearing in your thumbnail. If I go back into my viewport and hit a quick render, what this would give me is it will give me a simple bump maps in this image. So now basically we have converted the same image in a grayscale image within Maya, and we don't need to go into any other particular software to create a separate image for grayscale of that. And we all know that now we can come into this bump values map and control how much bump actually we need, and as per our requirement this bump would be adjusted accordingly, and this would just be exactly from the same image. So if you have done tiling or rotation and manipulation within the image, basically everything would just work fine because you have used the same image and all the nodes information is there. So this is a cool tip. This is Maya in 1 minute. See you around. Fiam on the love.